Hello, this is the luckiest maths teacher in the world. Thank you so much for tuning into this video on the balance method. So the idea behind this is simple. What you do to one side of the equal sign, one side of the equation, you must do to the other. So what we're going to do is undo what has been done to x, and we're going to do that in the opposite order to bid mass. So think of it like when you get dressed in the morning, you need to put on your shirt first and then your jumper. When you undress, you do it in the opposite order. You need to take off your jumper first and then your shirt. So it's the same when we're solving equations. Say I want to solve the equation 3x minus 4 is equal to 17. So I have times x by 3 and then subtracted 4. So because I times by 3 first, I need to undo that last. Just like with the dressed and undressed thing. So what I need to do first is undo subtracting 4. So I do that by adding 4. I need to add 4 to the left-hand side of the equation in order to undo subtracting 4. But the rule here says what I do to one side, I must do to the other. So if I've added 4 to the left-hand side, I must also add 4 to the right-hand side. That's why we call it the balance method. You're keeping everything in balance. So if I add 4 to the left-hand side, minus 4 and plus 4 undo each other. They just cancel each other out. Remember, I can't add 4 to 3x because they're not like terms. So what I'm left with, on the left-hand side, I just have 3x. On the right-hand side, I have 17 plus 4, which is 21. So now I'm going to undo timesing by 3 by dividing each side by 3. So if I divide the left hand side by 3, I divide the right hand side by 3. So 3x divided by 3 is x, because timesing 3 and dividing 3 undo each other, and 21 divided by 3 is 7. That is my solution, because 3 times 7 minus 4 does equal 17. So this is where the dressed and undressed analogy came in. So what I did to x was I dressed it by multiplying by 3. That's like putting on its shirt. Then I subtracted 4, which is like putting on its jumper. So when I undid things, I took the jumper off first. I undid the last thing that was done to x first. And then I undid the times 3 by dividing by 3. And that was like taking off the shirt. Where, because I multiplied by 3 first, that was the last thing I undid. So let's look at another couple of examples. Please pause and copy this down if you need. So let's have 4x minus 5 equals 35. So the first thing I need to undo is the minus 5 because it was the last thing done to x. So I undo that by adding 5. But if I add it to one side, I have to add it to both sides. So the next line is just 4x is equal to 40. And then I undo timesing by 4 by dividing by 4. And I get my solution, x equals 10. So what I do to one side of the equation, I must do the other. Now what I'm going to do now is change this equation slightly. So now I'm putting brackets in. So once again, this changes the order of operations. And if you change the order of operations, the answer you get will be different. So now what I've done to x is first subtract 5 from it, then times by 4. So what I need in order to undo this, I need to undo the timesing by 4 by dividing each side by 4. So if I divide the left-hand side by 4, I must divide the right-hand side by 4. So 4 times 4 and divide 4 cancel each other out. I'm just left with x minus 5 equals 35 divide 4. Now, that's not going to be a whole number. You can put it on your calculator if you want. You get 8.75. Now I need to undo subtracting 5 by adding 5 to each side. And I get x is equal to 13.75. So I chose these deliberately because I want you to know that even though we often get a whole number for the answer doesn't always need to be a whole number. Sometimes the answer will be a fraction or a decimal. In either case, we can substitute our answer into the original equation to check if it's true. You can just put this on your calculator, but change x for 13.75, and you'll get the answer 35. So I want to show you another way you could solve this equation. Have the equation 4 times x minus 5 equals 35. The other way you could solve is by expanding the brackets. So remember, when we expand the brackets, we're using the distributive law. It's called the distributive law because you distribute the 4 to the x, so it's 4 times x, and you distribute the 4 to the 5. So 4 times 5 is 20, and a minus here means a minus there. So we get 4x minus 20 equals 35. This equation and this equation are the same. They have the same solution. Now, because there's no brackets, it means that we've actually times x by 4 first, then subtracted 20. So this was the last thing I did, so it's the first thing I undo. I'm going to add 20 to both sides. So I get 4x is equal to 55. Of course, the plus 20 and minus 20 undo each other. So now I undo timesing by 4 by dividing by 4. So x is 55 divided by 4. You can use a calculator for that. You get 13.75, the same answer as I got before. Okay, so when you have brackets, you can choose to expand the brackets or solve it like I did in this one where I divided first. Okay, now we're going to look at a few examples involving fractions. So we are going to solve each of these equations using the balance method. They look very similar. The only difference is order of operations. And because of that, I will get a different solution. So let's look at the one on the left-hand side. So what I've done is taken x and I've divided. Remember, fraction line means divide. I've divided by 5. First, then added 9. So remember the dressed and undressed scenario. What I do last is what I must undo first. You put your jumper on last, it's the first thing you need to take off. So that's what we're going to do here. We're going to undo adding 9 first. So I'm going to subtract 9 from both sides of the equation. So plus 9 minus 9 undo each other. I'm left with x over 5. Now, 1 minus 9 is minus 8. I said before that your answer is not always going to be a whole number. It's not always going to be a positive number either. Sometimes I get a negative answer. So to undo dividing by 5, I'm going to times each side by 5. So then I get x, because times 5 and divide 5 undo each other, x equals minus 8 times 5, which is negative 40. I got a negative answer here. Again, you can check it on your calculator. If you put minus 40 over 5 plus 9 on your calculator, you will get 1. So we know we've done something right. So let's look at the one on the right-hand side. Let's look at this one here. So the only difference between this and the previous one, order of operations. So here I've added 9 first and then divided by 5. So what I need to do is first undo dividing by 5. I'm going to multiply each side by 5. So then I get, now this is where people get a bit mixed up. I don't times this top by 5. Timesing 5 and dividing 5 undo each other. So on the left-hand side, I'm just left with x plus 9. I don't times the x by 5. On the right-hand side, 1 times 5 is 5. So this is pretty easy to solve now. We undo adding 9 by subtracting 9. So we get 5 minus 9, which is minus 4. Once again, a negative answer. And if we put minus 4 plus 9 on our calculator divided by 5, we do get 1. We know we're right. So once again, different of order of operations means I get a different solution. It is vitally important that you get the order of operations correct. So not only do we need to make sure that what we do to one side, we do to the other, we must make sure that we're undoing what's been done to x, or whatever the pronumeral is. We must undo things in the opposite order to bid mass. All right, thank you so much for watching this video. First 3 people from my class that mentioned Caramello Koala, you get 1. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.